Hi, I'm Mari Windsor, and welcome to Guyam's Pink Ribbon Pilates. I've designed these workouts to get you into the best shape of your life in record time. And by my side, I have Susanna Catrone from my Hollywood studios demonstrating all the exercises for you. By adding the resistance band with Pilates moves, you will take advantage of the express benefits of seamless resistance, getting deeper Pilates action into your muscles and accelerating your results. With four complete 15-minute practices, you can mix and match for added variety or do all the workouts for a serious head-to-toe session. But it's entirely up to you. But this practice can meet all the demands of your busy lifestyle. Sometimes with our busy schedule these days, we have to kind of push working out off to the side. I want you to take that 15 minutes, find 15 minutes and energize your body so that you can have a great day every day. So let's get started. We're gonna use the band. It's gonna help us get into the muscles a little deeper so that you can get some great results with this Pilates 15-minute energizing workout. So just to feel what the band is like, I want you to hold it in between your thumb and your forefinger and just pull it across your body. Get used to that and release it with control. So we have resistance as you pull, and then we have counter resistance. So you're not just letting it go. We're always in control of the body and the band. All right, let's start with some breathing. Take the arms down. Inhale, reach the arms up, and exhale, and pull the arms down. I like the little pulling apart when the arms come down and up. That's nice. And up, and reach, and down, and pull. Again, up and reach, and down and pull. One more time. Up and reach with the arms, keeping the shoulders down and nice tall back. Now I want you to reach your arms up one more time. We're gonna inhale as we reach the arms around to the back and down to the hips. Look one way, holding your breath. Look the other way. Back to the center and exhale, bring the arms up. If you can't take your arms all the way back, just stop wherever it's comfortable for you. This is the important part. And back to center and up. Again, expanding the lung capacity as we hold the breath and look, holding the breath, back to center and exhale, up one more time. And inhale, deep breath in and look. Look, holding your breath back to the center and exhale with control and bring it back. Now we're going to do the Pilates 100. We're ready and warmed up. I want you to take your band across your shoulders like a shawl. So that's right on your shoulders. That's it, good. Now you're going to take your band between your thumb and your forefinger and slide it down a little bit and turn around and find that magic middle of your mat. And we're going to roll down with control. That's right. Bring your knees into your chest. Stretch your legs straight up. Rotate your legs in a Pilates first position, squeezing the heel so you activate that inner seam throughout the body and your inner thighs and your buttocks will benefit. So now I want you to take a deep breath in and exhale and lift up the head and shoulders. There we are into position. Pumping the arms, inhaling for a count of five and exhaling until we reach 100. And inhale, pump. And exhale. Now remember, when you do your breathing, don't give in to the movement of your arms and do a little choo-choo breath. Shh. That's not what I want you to do. I want you to deeply take the breath into the body so you can feed warm air and oxygen to the muscles so they can perform better. Squeezing the heels together, if your lower back is strong and your tummy is in, lower the legs down a little bit so you can get an extra added bonus and you'll feel your tummy a little bit more. Again, inhale and exhale. And I love using the band for the 100 because it helps you keep your shoulders down. Because sometimes when we pump the arms, the shoulders sort of slowly creep up. So this makes sure that your shoulders are down. Breathe out all the air, breathe it out, breathe it out, breathe it out. That's it. And bring your knees into your chest and lower your head down. Good job. Put the feet on the mat. Lengthen the legs out, activating the tummy as you go. Feel the length of the body. We're going to do an exercise I call the moving 100. So you're just going to lift your legs a little bit and lift your upper body a little bit and come down. But you have to activate your powerhouse to support that movement. Here we go, reaching with the arms and up, breathe out and down. and two, we have eight more. Three, push this down as you come up. Four, that's it. Squeeze the buttocks. Heels should be squeezing together. That inner seam is activated all the way through the body. Keep it going, don't stop. I know you might be feeling your tummy. That's the whole point. And that's it. And up and down and up and down and great. Now, we're going to do an exercise called coordination. And it's called that for a reason. We're going to start by moving the arms and legs together and then moving the legs and arms separately. So pull the ribs down and lift the head and shoulders up off the mat. The elbows are down on the mat. Reach with the arms and reach with the legs out. Hold your breath, open, close the leg. Exhale, just move the legs. Then when you're done, move the arms. Inhale, stretch it out. Open, close. Exhale, pulling the legs in and bend the elbows. Inhale again. Open, close, so you can see why it's called coordination, but it's also a great exercise to expand the lung capacity. And one more, and pull it in, and lower the head down. Now, take your band off your shoulders, and we're going to do this series of five, which is great for the abdominals. Instead of pulling the leg twice, we're gonna tug the band twice and bring the legs, moving them in and out. Keeping the legs inside the frame of the body, pull the ribs down, lift the head and shoulders off the mat, and lengthen one leg out to a 45 degree angle. And switch, one and two. See how she's tugging the band? So she's getting an extra added bonus in her arms. We love that. That's it, keep it going. And pull it in, and again, and in. Bring both knees in. Now, lift up your head again for me and stretch the arms and legs out and lengthen. Feel the length and the connection. Reach around, pull the band a little bit and exhale in. Inhale to stretch out, keeping the tummy down and the buttocks tight. Exhale, pull in. Again, inhale, reach long, pull the band and feel the power. That's it. And stretch. You want to be empowered and energized. This is your quality time that you're taking this 15 minutes and doing something very special for yourself. One more time, inhale, hold it there. Feel the length from your tummy to your toes and your tummy to your head and pull it in. Put your head down. Now bring the arms back up and put a little tension on the band. We're gonna stretch one leg up and take the other leg to a 45 degree angle. You will be tapping your leg on the band. If this flexibility is not what you have in your body, then bring the band down and just go there. That's fine. All right, lift up your head. We'll switch 10 times. And one, two, switch, two, two. While you're doing this, make sure that the legs are as straight as you can get them. The straighter your legs are, the more you're gonna feel that in your powerhouse. That's it. Now, bring your legs up, put your head down, and bend your knees. Unfold your band and place the band around your feet. Stretch your legs up and you can hold on with your hands in the middle with your elbows down by your side for support. You can keep your head down if you want to, but I'd like you to lift up your head for a little bit more energy and a little bit more tummy. Lower the legs down, inhale, exhale, pull up. Now with the support of the band, you can take your legs down a little bit lower than you normally would. So you're gonna get more work in that powerhouse. That tummy is gonna flatten up really nicely for you. And one more, and up. Bend your knees in and place your head down. Take your band off your feet, reach your arms up, one knee in, the other leg straight out. Keeping the legs inside the frame of your body, lift your head and shoulders off the mat and twist and reach the band over your bent knee. And one, switch, two, eight more times. Three, that's it, good. So this leg that's coming out of the hip, you wanna make it long and it needs to go to the same place each time. That's it. Now stay there, stretch both legs up. Move your band out of the way if you need to. Now we're gonna switch with straight legs a little faster. Here we go, and one, two, switch, one, two, switch, one, two, good, that's it, six more, and go one, and two, and three, and four, and five. Bring your knees into your chest and put your head down. Do you feel that energy just moving through the body now? That was great work. Take your band off your legs, put your feet on the mat, and use your tummy for control as you lengthen the legs out nice and slowly, and reach your arms back a little bit. We're gonna get ready to rock and roll. What I'd like you to do is really put a little tension on that band and roll right to your hip and balance. Be like a rock, right? Good. And other side, and hold your position. Use your powerhouse. Again, and hold. It's really kind of roll and rock, isn't it? So let's say that. And roll and pull. One more time. Great for the balance, great for the powerhouse and the connection, and back to center. Lower your legs down with control, bring your arms up, and let's take the band and open the band, and you're gonna lie on your side, and we're going to come to a plank position. You're gonna stabilize one end of the band with your hand and put the back leg in front, squeezing your buttocks. Now I want you to pull your arms out and in four times. One, and in, and pull it two, and in. And I love using the resistance band because you can gauge your own resistance. That's it, hold it there. And one more time, and out. Now you're gonna circle the arm and dip the hips, and up. This is challenging. Dip the hips, and up. Two more, dip and lengthen up. And one last time, and really reach with that arm, keeping the shoulders down. Come down with control, and let's swing your legs around and do the other side. Remember, you can gauge your own resistance so that if it feels a little too easy, you can always put your hand a little bit further up on the band. Here we go, and one, and down. Squeeze your buttocks, hold your balance. Legs are long, tummy is in, ribs are in. That's it, and last one, and down. Good, and up, one, and circle, and up, two, and circle, and up, three. Use your powerhouse. That's it. Don't let your shoulders come up when you sink down. And in. So when you're on your hand, don't let your shoulder do this while you're doing the exercise. Keep everything placed down in the back, all right? Now, let's do a little jackknife. So put your band on your feet, and you're gonna lie down with control on your back. I love having the support of the band. It allows you to really stretch through your back. Now, when you bring your legs over your head and you get ready to roll down, I want to make sure you do this with control and that you don't just fall into it, because that's a tendency for some people. Let's try it. Here we go. Over. Now lift your legs up. This is where you need the control. Slowly roll down. So you're lengthening your spine away from the top of your head. Again, over, and squeeze your bum and lift up. Now slowly lower down, pulling your tummy in and your ribs as well. Again, and over and up. Reaching with the arms, using the band to help you control the exercise. And one more time. And over and up. Squeeze your buttocks. Come on, up a little bit more. And slowly lower down. Don't just fall. Keep control. You control your spine from the front. That's it. We're ready to do some teasers, all right? Keep that energy going. Keep the movement going. Take your legs down to a 45-degree angle. You can rotate your legs open a little bit. Your heels are together and your toes are apart. Chin to your chest. Walk your hands up. I love using the band here for your teasers because it gives you a little bit more support. So if you've ever rolled down, if you've ever had trouble doing this exercise, I think your troubles are over. Chin to your chest and walk up. Make sure you're rolling through the spine, scooping under. Let's do this one more time. And come up, hold your balance. Now lower the legs down and up. One, and up, and two. Use your abdominals, use your powerhouse, squeeze your buttocks, that's it. And roll everything down together at one time. That's the challenge. Now bring everything up together at one time. Let's do that a couple more times. And come up. How's your tummy feeling? Are you pulling it in? And come down, because that's your control. And one more time, and come up. Stay there. What I'd like you to do is bend your knees and put your feet on the mat. Take a hold of the band, one on each hand. Keep your knees bent, pull your tummy in, and curl back, elbows by your side. Bring your fists to your shoulders, one. We'll do this 10 times. These are bicep curls. Now remember, when you do the bicep curls, you naturally have resistance bringing your hands to your shoulders. But I want you to have counter resistance coming back. It's like doing two exercises at one time. So it's very time efficient. What this workout is time efficient for you. That's it, keep going, and that's nice. Now, take your hands to the end, round four, keeping your tummy pulled in. Take your arms to the back like chicken wings, I like to say, and stretch your arms for triceps. One, remember that resistance. And don't snap your arms, don't snap your elbow. Keep the length of the body, keep the tummy engaged. And breathe. And five, resist it in. Six, use your tummy. And seven, three more, you can do it. Tummy is in. And I know you're feeling it back there, but that's really good. And that's it. Now round forward a little bit and take the band off your feet. Fold your band in half, turn around on your tummy. Reaching your arms out in front of you, putting a little tension on that band. You're gonna lift your arms up off the mat and your shoulders and your head as well. Lift your legs and swimming. One, two, three, that's it. Kick those legs. That's it, stay above water now. Good. You can pull the band across for an extra added bonus in your arms. Let's do double time. And one, two, three, four, five. Get that energy going in the body. You can feel it searing through your muscles. That's it. And come down. Now I want you to come to a seated position and place the middle of the band around one foot. Then you're going to go to a kneeling position and keep the band on the outside of the leg. Make sure you have a nice firm grip on that band. All right, stretch the leg out, one, and bring it in. Yes, we're working the buttocks. So in this whole 15 minutes, we've gotten every single part of your body. We've gotten your energy going. You're gonna have a great creative day. So keep it up, that's it. And seven, and eight, the hand should be underneath the shoulders and the tummy is in. And last one, stay there. Circle five each way, one, two, lengthen the back of that neck, three, four, don't let your shoulders sneak up on you, and reverse, one, two, three, four, and five, and bend your knee in. Now let's come to a seated position so we can be even and do the other side. Transitions are actually part of the movement, part of the workout, so we never stop the flow going. Never for a minute do you ever let your powerhouse go. And stretch it, one. And stretch it, two. And three. Keep your tummy engaged and pulled in. Squeeze your butt cheeks together. I know you feel this. Good, you're standing on your hip on the other side, so your knee is right underneath your hip. And last one, stay there and circle. One, nice, smooth, beautiful circles. That's it. No triangles, no squares, and reverse. Smooth from the powerhouse, lengthening the leg out at all times. And that's it. Bend your knee, take the band off your foot, and we're gonna shift back to child's pose with the arms out in front of you. Take a deep breath in here and breathe out. Come to a seated position and sit up and just take a moment and feel that energy surging through your body. It's fantastic. And remember that feeling for the rest of your day. You'll be more creative, more productive, and just know that you've done something good for yourself. This is your sculpting workout with the band. When we add resistance to the length of the muscles, you're going to sculpt and tone twice as fast. We simulate a lot of the exercises we do on the equipment with the resistance of the band. So let's get to it. Let's do your footwork. So take your band and put it around your feet and roll down with control. Remember, everything is with control. Make sure your head is on the mat. Bring your knees into your chest. Open your knees and place the band inside the legs. Your toes are apart and your heels are together. Squeezing your heels will help to activate your inner thighs and your buttocks, and I want you to feel as though you have high heel shoes on. Stilettos, maybe. All right, imagine that. Here we go. Stretch out the legs on one and resist it back in. When you do this movement of stretching and bending, try not to snap the knees. Try to have equal energy every place you go. So it's like one long seamless line. Stretch and back. Now I want you to lift up your head. We get a little extra added bonus working the tummy. And in. And two. That's it, resist it back. We have resistance and counter resistance. And one more, resist and counter resist and lower the head down. Let's change positions of the band on the foot. You go to your arches now. Now we curl the toes over like a little bird on a perch. And we're going to do the same movement, but now your legs are together. And you can work to squeeze your legs together so you're feeling that inner seam all the way through the body, that beautiful Pilates connection. Here we go, and stretch out. One, nice and long. Keep the tailbone down, keep the torso nice and long, keep the ribs in, and keep a firm grasp on the band. That's it. And one more. Now let's add an extra added bonus and work that tummy. Look at your belly button, stretch it out and in. And lengthen the legs out. Remember not to snap the knees, make everything even. We're moving, we're getting the energy going in the body, we're sculpting, and lower the head down. Now change the position of the band on the feet and go right to your heels. Stretch your toes towards you. This is going to help you activate the back side of your leg a little bit better. So we're getting all parts of the legs, yes? Here we go. And stretch. One. And pull it in. And two. So resist it to come in. So you have even energy going out and pulling in. Two more. And stretch. And in. One more time and stretch. And in. Now let's get that tummy activated. Lift up and stretch. One. And in. And two. Lengthen it out. Remember, the tailbone stays long as you bend your knees. That's very important in Pilates. And last one. And in. And lower the head down. Let's go back to the toes. All right. On your tiptoes, you can either have your toes turned out and your heels together, or you can have your legs parallel, whichever you'd like to do. Stretch your legs out, and we're going to lower the legs down and up five times, using the band for support in the lower back. Here we go. Let's lift up the head, and five times down, and press it up. Don't just pop those legs up. Feel equal energy each way. That's where you get the work. And one more time, down and up. Lower your head down, bend your knees, and let's come to a seated position. I think you can just do it right from there. That's perfect. We're ready to do our rowing. I love the rowing series, especially with a little bit of resistance. It really simulates what we do on our equipment in the studio, and it sculpts your arms, your shoulders, and your upper back. And pull the tummy in and round your back. Stay there in that position as you open your arms to the side. Round forward as you take your arms around to the back. Look at that back working, it's beautiful. Lift up the arms and around and sit up. And now let's count for six. Here we go. Inhale, lean back. Exhale, open the arms on two. Inhale, round forward, three. Reach the arms up, four, five, and sit up, six. One more time. And back, open the arms to the side. Pull around to the back. Reach your arms up and over and sit up tall. We'll change positions of the arms. Now you're at right angles. Keep this position as you lean back. That's part of the challenge. And look at the biceps in those arms. Don't you feel your biceps working? Sit up tall. And round forward, take your arms around to the back. Reach up and over and sit up again. Sitting up tall, lengthen the spine. Take the body weight of the torso off the hips. We're decompressing the body at this time. The more you decompress, the more the organs and the spine are happy. Lean back again, lean back, ribs in, and reach forward and round forward. Take your arms around to the back, lift up and over and stretch. Good. Sitting up. Now let's take the band and slide it up. So we're almost sitting on the band there. It's right underneath your thighs. All right, let's continue with our rowing. Take the hands to the chest. Your band is between your thumb and your forefingers. Stretch out and inhale. Lower the arms down without collapsing in the body. And inhale, sit up tall and press open. And good. So as you're moving the arms, the torso doesn't collapse at all. We continue to take the body weight of the torso off the thighs. And if you squeeze your butt cheeks together a little bit, you'll have a little bit more luck in pulling up in your waist. And up and press it open. Now flex your feet. Round forward and reach your hands past your toes. And roll up through the spine, sitting up tall. Press the arms open and get taller, 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 yes. And again, reach. Now roll up through the spine, sit up tall, and open the arms. reaching and lifting taller. And one more time, and reach. Rolling up through the spine, sitting up tall, and press open, don't lean back. All right, keep your arms in your peripheral vision. Now cross your legs in, or put the bottoms of the feet together, whichever is more comfortable. We're going to take the thumb and the forefinger together and raise the arms up to your forehead. Lean forward, this is like a salute. Here we go, six times. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Now let's reverse the breathing. Exhale, inhale, exhale, and exhale, good. Sit up tall, take the arms open to the side. This is called hug a tree in Pilates. The elbows are bent. It's almost as if the arm were resting on water, all right? So the elbow's not dropped down, but the elbow is up and the shoulders are down and the chest is lifted and you feel elegant and beautiful. Here we go. Pull, inhale, exhale. Again, inhale, keep your arms in your peripheral vision. Be able to see your arms at all times. Now reverse the breathing. That's it, and inhale. Exhale, and inhale. One more time, exhale and resist it back. That's it, and lower the arms down. Nicely done. There's nothing better to tone the thighs and the buttocks than the side kick series with the band. So let's take the band and place it on one foot. Make sure it's in the middle so you can grab the end of the bands equally. Lie down on your side. Have a firm grip on the band with your hand and place it in front of you. Your tummy is in and you're thinking about good posture. Lift the leg hip height. We're going to swing the leg forward and back six times. And one, swing it back. Two. Now when you're swinging the leg, make sure the leg is even with the hips. You don't want the leg to go higher than the hip to the back. And forward and back. One more time. And forward and back. Bring the legs together. I want you to do little bitty circles about the size of a cantaloupe, five each way, and go one, two, three, from the hip, and reverse, one, two, three, four, five. Now that you've got that circular motion, let's continue and make it big. Here we go, forward lift, back and down, forward lift, back and down. Again, one more time, make it smooth. Now reverse, and front, back, reach up, forward, and together one more time, and together. Now, I love this part. So take your leg to the back, lengthen, keep it even with the hip, and really feel the leg as if I'm pulling it, so you're making the leg longer. We're gonna do 20 pulses here. One, two, three, four. As you do these pulses, you're gonna feel this right in the lower glutes. It's a wonderful, wonderful way to lift up the buttocks so that you have a great rear view when you turn around. That's it. And bring your legs together. That was beautiful. Now turn the leg out a little bit so the knee is sort of facing towards the ceiling and you're gonna kick the leg up and down six times. And one, press it down. And two, press it down. Three, that's it, lengthen the leg. Remember, don't just like let the leg fall. Don't give in to that resistance. You have to do a little work from the powerhouse. Take the leg halfway up. Rotate the leg so the kneecap is facing front. 10 pulses, a little slower. One, two, three. Really lengthen that leg, reach to the heel, that's it. Keep the leg nice and long, and lower the leg down. Bend the knees up, and keep the band in between the knees. Lift the leg up so you have a little space to be able to stretch the band. I call these push away, 10 times, and one, resist it in. Now remember, when you're stretching that leg, try not to snap the knee. You're lengthening and you're using your powerhouse for control. So you have lengthened and resisted back in. Don't let it snap. That's right. And pull it in. And stretch. And in. Tummy's in. Shoulders are down. You should really be starting to feel this now. And relax down. Take the band off the foot. We're going to do our leg lift sculpt series. So take the front, take the loop of the band in the front of the legs and take the ends of the band around to the back and thread them through. I know it might take you a minute the first time. That's it. If you need more resistance, you can always pull your hand up on the band or let it go a little bit. So lift the leg up and down 10 times. One and two. That's it. Now when you're lifting the leg up and down, make sure that the hip stays right on top of the other hip, so you're not letting one hip fall back. So the knees should always be directly on top of one another. Good. When you do this exercise and you start to feel it, don't tense up in your shoulders, just a little tip. Feet together, open, close. One, and two, and keep smiling. I know you're starting to feel this, but that means it's working. It's really working. This is so powerful to do. And it's gonna empower you, and it's gonna make you feel so much better. That's it. Now I think we're gonna take the band off the leg and flip around to the other side. So come to a seated position again. Put the band on the foot. Make sure it's in the middle of the band and slide the hands up. Gauge that. Lie down on your side. Get a nice firm grasp on that band and down you go. We're ready to go forward and back 6 times. And one, take it to the back. And always remember to keep the leg even with the hip. You don't want to take it up too high. It might compromise your back. Keep the tummy in and the powerhouse engaged at all times. Make a nice smooth line. That's it. And legs together. Little bitty circles about the size of a grapefruit or cantaloupe. Here we go. One, two. I always like to think of food around this time. It kind of helps me get through it. One, two, three, four, five. And legs down. Big circle and go broad. Lift and down. Beautiful, graceful movement. You get even energy every place you go. No squares, no triangles. Reverse and down. Reverse up and down. Again, reverse up and down. Now we have a little arabesque pulse here. Remember, I'm standing here and I'm pulling your leg. Try to imagine that. Try to get that mind-body connection and really feel the leg get longer. 20 pulses up and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. You feeling that in your butt cheek yet? I certainly hope so. The second side sometimes can be a little bit more intense than the first side. That's it. Bring your legs together. Now, let's rotate the leg up and we're going to kick up and down 6 times. And one, resist it down. Remember, equal each way. Don't just let the leg fall. Feel the resistance of the band because then you're really getting deeply into the glute muscles. That's what you want. And down. Now halfway up, kneecap is facing front. 10 slower pulses than the arabesque. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. 5, 6. Lengthen that leg out. Keep it longer. Pull the tummy in and lower the leg down. Bring both knees up for the pushaways. Band is in the middle. Make sure you got that firm grip on the band. And let's push away. And one, resist it in. Lengthen, don't snap the knee. And lengthen and pull it in. Feel the resistance, take advantage of it. This is your time to change your body. And changing your body can change your life. That's it, pull it in. And stretch, you have 2 more. And stretch and bring it in. Lengthen the leg and sculpt it in. That's it. Take the band off your foot. We're going to do our leg lift sculpt. Bring the band around your legs and thread it through the middle. And we've got a secure place in the band. Again, if you need more or less resistance, make that adjustment. Here we go. Lifting the leg up and down. 9 more times. 2, 3, 4. Don't give up. 5, keep it going, and you don't need to lift that leg up too high. Just feel it, you know, you're gonna really get a nice burn in this area. So just keep it steady, keep it going, and keep it even. Feet together, open, close the knee. 1, 2. Don't just let the knee fall. Resist it to come down. Up, resist it down, that's it. Feel the resistance of the band. Take advantage of the resistance and the counter resistance. That's it, 2 more. And last one. Take the band off your legs and come to a seated position. Those are some great sculpting exercises that you can do if you're interested in really getting some tone and sculpting and length in your arms, legs, and buttocks. In Pilates workout, we always try to create a flow in the body, which gives you dynamics and rhythm. So let's get started. I want you to lie down on your back for the Pilates 100. Find the middle of your back, roll down with control. Now, usually we do the 100 with the arms pumping. You always see this position in the breathing, smoothly in through the nose for a count of five and out through the nose for a count of five until we reach 100. This time we're gonna beat the legs instead of pumping the arms. You have a large artery in your leg that goes right to your heart, so you're still gonna warm up your heart and lungs and get your circulation going. So stretch your legs up, rotate the legs open in your Pilates first, feeling that inner seam connected through the body. Lower the legs down a bit, take a deep breath in, pull the ribs in as you lift the head and shoulders up off the mat, keeping your arms down. Let's beat the legs and breathe. Inhale. Exhale. Now, as you do this, if your legs are really lengthened, you're also going to feel your inner thighs, which is great because the inner thighs are a really difficult place to get toned up. So this is going to work those inner thighs too. That's a bonus. We like bonuses. That's right. And breathe. Now, as you breathe out, make sure you're pulling your tummy in. Keep your buttocks as tight as you can. And if you want a little variation, you can actually cross beat your legs and keep your breathing smooth. Go back to regular beating, and you can take your legs down a little bit lower to really get into those abdominals. That's very advanced at eye level. I don't recommend you doing this if you have a weak lower back. Bring your knees into your chest and put your head down. Put your feet on the mat, and with control, lengthen your legs out. Now, shift yourself around so that your head and your feet are on your mat. If it's come off, that's it, good. Reach your arms up to the ceiling. Pull your ribs away from your hands, squeeze your buttocks, toes are open, heels are together. Reach your arms up to the ceiling, your head follows, curving forward, and exhale. Inhale, reaching with your arms, scoop under the hips, squeeze your inner thighs and buttocks, and exhale back. Nice and slow again, inhale to come up, and exhale forward, articulating the spine with the use of the powerhouse. So the more you pull this in, the more you're going to be able to articulate and control the spine. One more time, nice and slowly, and stretch, and roll down, inhale, and exhale as you go. Let's pick up the tempo for some dynamics. Here we go, inhale, reach, good. Exhale down, flat. Inhale, reach, and stretch. Exhale down, one more time, inhale, reach, stretch, exhale down and flat. Now, just because you're going faster doesn't mean that you lose control. So take your arms down by your side. So that's something for you to practice. Bring your knees into your chest and stretch your legs up. We're gonna squeeze the buttocks and pull the tummy in and take the legs over the head. And remember, if you can't take your legs over and touch your feet to the mat, you can keep your legs at a parallel level. The important part of this exercise is to control the spine rolling down. Arms are firmly planted by your side. Take your legs over your head and open the feet, flex the toes. Now point the feet and roll down with control. Again, legs together and over and open. Keep the thighs close to the chest for more control in the body. Again, over and open and rolling down, point the feet, lengthen the legs. Now reverse it, over, open and close. Now you're gonna get a deeper stretch as you roll down. Take your legs over, open and close. And exhale and try to keep the thighs close to the chest. One more time and close, point your feet. Now reach your legs away from your hips as you roll down. Nice and controlled. Didn't that feel good? I know, I heard that sigh, that was nice. All right, now I want you to reach your arms up and we're gonna come to a seated position in one fluid motion. Take your hands by your side and scooch your hips forward, bending your knees into rolling like a ball. Take your hands on your ankles, drop your head down, push off with your feet and balance. Imagine that I'm stuffing you into a little suitcase. I'm gonna take you to Europe with me, right? So you wanna go in my suitcase. How many times have you said that? All right, so here's your chance. Pull the tummy in away from your thighs and roll back and come up. Again, keep yourself in that suitcase and back and up. One more time. Don't look back where you're going. Keep your head down. That's it. Now, right from there, I want you to elongate your legs up and straighten your arms. Pull the tummy in, keep your arms straight, and drop your chin a little bit and roll back. And come right back up. Powerhouse is attached to the lower back. And again, back and come up. And again, two more. Back and up. And one more time. Give it all you got and come up and balance. Nicely done. Bring your legs together and bend your knees. Put your feet on the mat. Take your hands by your hips and scoot yourself back and place one leg on top of the other for boomerang. That's it. Hands by your side. Pull your tummy in, drop your head down, and roll back. Open, close the legs. Roll up to a teaser balance. Scoop your arms around to the back. Lengthen your arms. Roll forward, lower your legs down, and release the hands and stretch like the dying swan. Here we go again. And back, open, close, and roll up. Reach with the arms and legs. Take your arms back, lower the legs down, and exhale as you bring your arms around. Inhale and roll back. Hold your breath, open, close, exhale up to your teaser. Inhale, take your arms around to the back, lower the legs, and exhale around. One more, and inhale, roll back. Open, close, and roll up. And arms back around. Feel that nice lift in the chest as you exhale and pull around. Sit up tall. Unhook your feet there and lift your hips and take your hips to the front and bend your knees. Open your knees and thread your hands through. We're going to do the seal. And beat your feet, one, two, three, and roll back. One, two, three, and up. One, two, three, hold your balance back there. One, two, three, and up. One, two, three, and back. You have one more set to do, make it a good one. Rolling through the spine, relieving all that tension and stress in the spine. Put your feet down and scoot yourself back. Roll down with control. We're gonna go right into the neck pull. But I want you to do the neck pull with your hands on your legs just for a little bit more support. Flex your feet, chin to your chest, and roll up, hands on your legs, and roll forward. Sit up tall, hands behind the head, elbows open to the side. Lean straight back, pull your tummy in, and contract and roll down with control. Reach your arms around to your thighs again. Chin to your chest and roll forward. Keep your back curved the whole time. Sit up tall now and lean back, holding your breath, and exhale, pull your tummy in, squeeze your buttocks, and roll down. Now guess what? Challenge yourself. You can do it. If you can't quite get all the way up, keep trying. Here we go. Inhale to come up. Exhale, forward. Sit up tall. Inhale, hold your breath, lean back. Exhale, rolling down. Again, inhale, roll up and over. Sit up tall and lean back. Pull your tummy in and exhale and roll down. Bring your arms down by your side, and if you find that your head has come off the mat, scoot yourself down a little bit and we'll do the jackknife. Bring your knees into your chest and stretch your legs up. You're going to take your legs over your head parallel to the mat. Lift your legs up to the ceiling, squeezing your buttocks and activating your powerhouse. Roll down with control. And take your legs over again. Squeeze your buttocks and lengthen your legs up. Lower your legs a little bit so that you have more control as you roll down. Two more times. And over, squeeze it up. Lower your legs down a little bit and pull your tummy in. Remember, the front supports the back. One last time. Keep your arms long and your shoulders down. And roll down, lowering your legs a little bit with control. This is great for your buttocks too, by the way. That's another extra added bonus. We like those bonuses. Bring your knees into your chest. Stretch your legs out on the mat and turn over on your tummy for the leg pull down. Your hands are right underneath your shoulders. Your feet are flexed. Your buttocks is tight. Push yourself up in one unit. One piece of steel from your head to your heel. Lift up one foot and shift the heel back. And come in and switch legs. And squeeze it back. Your challenge here is when you lift up your leg, not to lift up your seat as well. To keep your buttocks nice and tight and flat and your lower back long. One more time. That's right. Now take one foot in front of the other and one hand behind the other and swoop around for your beautiful transition for your leg pull up. Lift one leg up and flex it down. Other side, lift it up. Don't lower that seat. And lift up. We're working the buttocks too. That's it. I love working the buttocks. It works. It's great. Now bend the knee and go on your knee for a beautiful transition for your kneeling side circle kicks. circle the leg 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Forward and back 4 times. Try not to collapse in your chest at all. Keep your body long. Keep both sides of the rib cage reaching. That's it. And the hand stays right underneath the shoulders. Now, we're going to do a little bending of the knee, which we call an attitude, which isn't the toss of your head, but it's working the buttocks. That's it. Take the leg back as far as you can, stretching the thigh. Pulse up for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring your knee down and come back up to your T position on your knees. Now, if you're not in the middle of the mat, make that adjustment at this time. Go down to the other side and stretch the leg out, squeezing the buttocks and bringing the hips forward. You want to try to have a straight line from your waist all the way down to your toe. Little circles, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. With control from the powerhouse. Forward and back. Don't rock forward and back on your arm. Just rock your leg forward and back. That's it. And back. One more time. And back. Give me that little attitude now. That's it. Take the thigh back. Feel the stretch in your quad. Pulse up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Bring your knees together. Back to that beautiful T position. Take a breath. Take a moment. Shift in your hip and sit down for your beautiful mermaid. Hold on to your top ankle. Extend one arm up, feeling the length from the waist all the way to the fingertips, and reach over and exhale. Inhale, come up, take your hand down to the mat, and exhale, reaching long. And come up, inhale and exhale. Curving the hand around the head will help you stretch a little bit deeper. And up, take the hand down and lengthen long. And bring your body back up. Now reach your arms in back of you and stretch your legs out for a beautiful teaser transition. She does it so well. Here we go, arm up. Exhale and reach over. Notice how, again, she has the arm curved over the head. It allows her to stretch a little deeper. Bring your arm up and bring your hand down. And exhale, go down to your elbow and lengthen from your hip all the way through your hand. Push yourself back up. And again, curve your arm around your head. And come back to a seated position. Take your hand down on the mat. Go to your elbow and reach long. And come back up. Now we're in a perfect position to do some beautiful planks. So stretch your legs out. They're right into position. One leg is in front of the other. And push yourself up on your arm and hold your balance. Dip your arm through the center and lift your hips. With control, come back and sit gracefully back down onto the mat. Let's try that again and lift up. Now I want you to open your chest to the ceiling and come back to a straight line position and slowly lower down. Now let's do a little combination. Here we go, and lift up. Now scoop under, lifting up your hips. Bring your arm around and sweep it open to the front. Feel elegant and beautiful. And come back and come down with control. Here's another teaser transition to the other side. Stretch, we do it whenever we can. We want to keep that flow going. Nothing ever stops. Stretch your legs out. Now lift up, squeezing your buttocks, pressing your hips forward. Scoop your arms down, lifting your hips. Come back to a nice, long, beautiful plank position and sit with control back down on your mat. And again, lift up and open your heart to the ceiling and look to see where your heart went. There it is. And come back and down you go. Now let's do a combination and lift up, squeezing your buttocks and pulling your tummy in. Scoop under, lifting your hips. And come back, sweep your arm, open your heart to the ceiling as best you can, pressing your hips forward and sit down with control. Nicely done. That's a challenge. Turn over on your tummy. Bend your knees and grab onto the tops of your feet. We're gonna just arch up and down 3 times. Lift up the body and lift the thighs off the mat and come down. Lift up the body, lifting the thighs off the mat and come down. One more time and lift up. Now stay there with control. Release your hands from your legs and sweep your arms around to the front and let's swim. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's pick up that tempo. Come on, the sharks are coming. Let's go, we gotta swim fast. That's it, good. Keep that rhythm in the body and lower down with control. Take your hands underneath your shoulders and push your hips back to your heels for a beautiful little piece of heaven and stretch. Inhale. And a nice long exhale to finish the breath. Now you can go ahead and come to a seated position, and you've done a great job creating dynamic flow and rhythm in your own body. Plus we've done a little toning and sculpting too. This exercise routine is 15 minutes long, and it's to restore and stretch the body, lengthening the muscles, feeling good. It really feels nice when you take the breath deep into the body and lengthen the muscles out. It helps you to relax, and it does restore the body. So that if you have a lot of tension and you need to chill, so to speak, this is a great workout for you to do. Or if you have trouble sleeping at night, I recommend you do this routine before you get into bed and you'll be very calm. So we're gonna calm the body down. So let's start with the band with the legs crossed and bringing the band in front of you and taking it around to your back. Thank you. Now you will see this move again. The band around the back really helps to support what we're trying to do here. Throughout the workout, you'll see this again. So you're gonna round your body forward, take your tummy in and reach your arms. Feel the resistance of the back going into the band and the arms reaching forward. Rolling up and relax the arms back on the legs. Now exhale as you round forward, pulling the tummy into the back, and the band really does give you a great reference point. And roll up through the spine. Remember, we're moving slowly and with accuracy, so you need to use your powerhouse. And roll up through the spine. Let's do this one more time. And exhale, really pull the tummy in even a little bit deeper and reach the arms a little bit further. Feel that opposing force of energy. And roll up through the spine. You know, the body acts much like the band. That two-way stretch in the band is often how your muscles react when you stretch. You always need a two-way stretch, all right? So let's go ahead and take the band and reach your arms out in front of you. Now I want you just to pull the band across your body and feel what's working here. This part of your arm and right above the bra strap. We like to work that area. As a matter of fact, you can pick this band up anytime during the day and go, oh, I think I need to work this part of my arm. And just do this 10 times, put the band down and get on with your day. That's it. And one more time. Now I'd like you to keep the band a little stretched and we're gonna reach the arms up and inhale. Pull the band apart once you get your arms up there and exhale, bring the arms down and pull the band apart again. Let's do that 3 more times. And inhale, and exhale. You can feel this underneath part of your arm working. We love that. And pull, and down. Nice, slow, controlled movement. And up, last one, and down. That's the way. Now you can fold your band in half. We're gonna stretch to the side and swoop around. As we swoop around to the front, you're gonna feel that same position that we felt when the arms were reaching forward. You'll see. Here we go, stretch to the side and lift up. And stretch to the side and lift up. Now you're gonna swoop around, get that curve in the spine, open your shoulders and chest to the front and up. I told you, you'd see it again. And over and up, and over and up. Now reach to the side, elongate, breathing as you reach around, and come up. Release the arms down. Now I'd like to stretch the hamstrings a little bit. I love using the band to stretch the hamstrings because you get a little bit of resistance. You can get deeper into the muscles. So let's stretch one leg out. And the other knee is bent and the foot is at the crook of the knee. Reach forward and put the band on the bottom of your foot and hold on to the band with both hands. Walk your hands towards the foot and round forward and exhale. Inhale and roll up through the spine. Let's do that one more time. And pull the tummy in. Here's the same place with that resistance of reaching back in your tummy. Remember the band on your back. And roll up. Now let's go down one more time and flex and point the foot. Stay there and flex and point. And flex. When you flex, you get the bottom of the leg. When you point, you reach through the front. So calf and shin, right? Everything is activated equally. Now roll up through the spine, hold on to the band, and you're going to bend your elbow and twist from your waist and hold. Nice waist exercise and a great stretch for your ribs, and come back to center. Make sure when you do that you keep both sides of the rib cage equal. Your back is like a spiral staircase, so it's not like this. It's twisting and lifting, right? Here we go, walking towards the foot. There's that position again. And walk up. Again, and round forward. Good, and walk up. Let's do one more time, and we'll flex and point the foot. See if you can stretch a little bit deeper into the hamstring. Flex the foot, feel the calf. Point the foot, feel the top of the leg. And flex and point. Two more times. Flex and point. Last one, flex and point. Now roll up, stack the vertebra as you sit up tall, and take your band in one hand, and you're gonna twist from the waist. Remember, you lift to twist. Right, keep both sides of the rib cage even, and come back with control. Don't just let the band snap. That's not a good idea, all right? Now we're ready to begin to do some exercise, some rolling exercises, to further restore the spine and stretch out the body. Put both feet in the band and maybe scooch forward a little bit so your feet are at the front edge of the mat so you have room to roll down. Take your band in both hands, pull the tummy in, scoop the hips underneath you, use your band to help you roll down vertebra by vertebra. Now if you've ever had trouble doing this, this is a great way to train your body to work with control. And forward. And again, rolling down. And rolling up. Take it easy. Don't overstretch it. Don't overwork it. Be in control of your body at all times. And roll up. One more time. Scoop under vertebra by vertebra. Go slowly enough so you can name each vertebra on the way up. Here we go. You got dogs, cats, whatever. Name those vertebra. That's it. Good. Beautiful. Now let's take the band off your feet. Bring your knees in towards you. Make sure you have enough room because we're going to do the roll over. So take the band to the buttocks and hold on to both ends as the band is folded in half and roll down with control. Bring your knees into your chest. Now, when you do your rollover, if you can't touch your feet on the floor behind you, like maybe our model is going to do here, simply keep your legs parallel. The main idea is to have control rolling down on the spine, to relieve that tension in the spine. Here we go. Squeeze your buttocks, pull your tummy in, and over flex your toes. Open, keep your thighs close to your chest as you roll down, lengthening your spine away from the top of your head. Legs together, squeeze your buttocks, pull your tummy in. Open the legs, point the feet, slowly roll down with control. Again, and over. Make sure you don't just fall down the spine when you're rolling down. You have resistance with the legs reaching out the other way and being close to the chest. Now let's do it a little deeper. Over, open. Now close your legs, squeeze your inner thighs together, squeeze your buttocks and roll down. Again, over, open. Inhale and close and exhale slowly as you roll down. One more time and over and pull. Legs together, keep your thighs close to your chest, reach your feet away from your buttocks as you roll down. Take your band from behind your back and put the band on one foot. Make sure it's in the middle and take your band and hold on, bring your elbows to your side. The other leg is reaching straight down from your hip. This leg is important too when we do our single leg circles. We're gonna do this 5 times, keeping the leg inside the frame of the body. Nice and slow and easy, here we go. Cross down and up. Again, cross down and up. Cross down and up. and circle that leg. Keep the torso still. The elbows by your side will help you to stabilize your torso. Reverse. Down, cross, and up. Down, cross, and up. Again, I also want you to think about this leg. This leg stays perfectly still. It's lengthened and glued to the floor. Now, here comes my favorite part. Take your hands on each band and reach your arms up. Give yourself a little extra stretch. Feel the stretching along the back of the leg and also feel the stretch along the thigh and the front of the leg so you have an opposing force of energy, a two-way stretch. All right, let's switch legs. Put the other foot in and lower the other leg down. Everything is moving slowly like we're moving through wet cement. This is how you're gonna restore the body and stretch it out long. Here we go, and cross down and up. Again, cross down and up. Ribs are in. Try to keep the whole back on the mat and the hips still. Remember, I don't like that hula dancing. Save it for Hawaii. And down, cross, and up. Down, cross, and up. Down, cross, and up. Shoulders down, neck is long. And last one. Now here comes the best part. Reach your arms over your head and lengthen the leg. Feel that two-way stretch in the body. And take the band off your foot. Now we're gonna do a single leg stretch and a double leg stretch. So bring your arms up above your chest, pulling on the band. You're gonna tug the band twice instead of tugging the leg when it comes in. So stretch one leg out, the other knee is in. Pull your ribs down, lift up your head. And tug the band, one, two, switch, two, and three. Make sure when you're doing this exercise that the legs stay inside the frame of your body. So don't take the legs out here, don't let them wander. You can actually see them, so it's a good time to use that eyesight to help you control. This is the double leg stretch. Inhale, stretch everything up. This is your two-way stretch again. And pull around. Again, inhale, stretch it long. And pull the arms around. Again, inhale, stretch long, two ways from the center. And inhale, stretch, and pull it in. And again, inhale, stretch, pull that band, and in, last one. Stretch, now hold it there. Really feel that two-way stretch. Pull down, squeeze the heels, lengthen the arm, whoo, and pull it in. That was beautiful. Put your head down. Now keep your band on your shins. We're gonna sit up for your spine stretch forward, and come up in one count. That's beautiful. Let go of your band, put your hands by your hips and find the middle of your mat and stretch your legs. Reach and get your band and flex your feet. Your legs are hips width apart and your feet are nice and flexed. Feel that tension. All right, press your band apart a little bit and here comes that same place where we're gonna round the back just like we did in the beginning. Imagine your back pulling into a band as you roll up and inhale. And exhale, round forward, pull your back into the band and pull your tummy tight as you roll up, stacking the vertebra. And again, exhale, reach with the arms a little bit further this time. Pull your back back a little bit further also and sit up tall. One more time and exhale down. Reach, now let's stay there for a minute. Pull your tummy back, feel that two-way stretch of your tummy going back and your arms reaching forward, deepen it. That's it, and rolling up. You can take your legs just a little bit further apart and we'll do a saw. So twist from your waist, round forward again. Feel that two-way stretch as you reach forward, reach a little bit further, reach a little bit further. Now roll up through your spine in the twist and come back to center. Again, twist and round forward and reach. Pull your tummy in as the arms reach forward. That's your two-way stretch. And roll up and come back to center. Again, twist and reach your leg from underneath. Reach right through the heel. Make that leg longer as you reach. That's it, and come up in your twist and back to center. One more time for good luck. And round one and two. Last one, three. Lengthen those legs as you roll up through your spine and come back to center. Now I'd like you to go up on your knees in the middle of your mat facing front. This is your chest expansion with the band, and I love the chest expansion with the band because it really gives you a point of reference and helps you keep your torso really still and open. So reach your arms out in front. I want you to inhale, press the band against your thighs and pull your hands back. And look one way holding your breath, and look the other way holding your breath back to the center. And exhale, reach your arms up. And again, inhale, press it back. Crack a walnut between your shoulder blades. Now we're expanding the capacity of your lungs as we work. Again, inhale and stretch, look and look back to the center and exhale, reach your arms up. One more time, squeeze and look and look. You're also getting a bonus in your arms right now. I hope you realize that. All right, let's shift the hips and sit. Unfold your band and place your band underneath your shins. This is a mermaid, but it's a little bit different. You're gonna keep your arms extended to the side and just go side to side four times. Here we go. And reach it long and luxurious and stretch and up. Let's take that breath and exhale. Inhale, fill the lungs up with air and exhale, bring the lungs out. Again, up and reach long and come up. That's it. Now take your hands down and let's just stretch out in a beautiful teaser and come around to the other side. Take your band again, stabilize the body. Here we go and exhale, reach long. Inhale, feel the air, yes. And feel the air circulating through the body as you do this stretch. The more you inhale deeply and take warm air and oxygen to the muscles, the better and more relaxed you'll be able to stretch. And reaching long with the body, that's it. And come up. Now let's get those hamstrings working and your back. So turn on your side and you're gonna take the band under one foot and the other leg is straight out in front of you. Bend the knee into the chest. Now you're gonna stretch the leg and bend the knee. Again, as you stretch your leg, please don't move your back. This is also a back exercise, not just a hamstring exercise. One more time. Now, take your band and walk your hands towards your feet, and now round forward. Take a deep breath in and rolling up. Sit up tall. And round forward one more time. Stay there and flex the foot and point. And flex and point. Two more times. Flex and point and flex and point. Now we're gonna walk your hands along the band as you roll down on your spine. Remember, if you can't stretch your legs as much as you see the model doing, please don't worry about it. Do the best that you can. Listen to your body. Don't overstretch. Lift your head and walk up. That's it. And walk down one more time. And with control, head first and roll up to a seated position. That's beautiful. Now let's switch legs. And stretch the leg out and the other leg is bent into you. Bend the knee in. Now stretch the leg and bend the knee. Again, lengthen and keep your back nice and tall. Keep your neck long and your chest open and your shoulders down. That's it. Now walk your hands up and stretch forward. Now you get to round your back. Now sit up tall and walk your hands back a little bit. Get your back up tall. Round forward. Yes, one more time. I saw that. Stay there and flex your foot and point. And flex. Feel the top of your leg. Feel the bottom of your leg. Feel the top of your leg. Bottom and top. Good. Now you're going to roll down, scooping the hips underneath you with ease and control, using the band for support. And up you go, chin to your chest. Let's try that one more time. And walk your hands on the band and roll down. Chin to your chest first, ribs in, and walk back up. That's it. Get your back nice and tall for that last little second. Bend the knee in and take the band off the foot. Fold it in half and turn around on your tummy. Reaching your arms out, feel a little tension on the band so you have your arms are working. And you're gonna arch up and down. Up and come down. Now remember, if you can't arch up as much as Susanna can do, just do the best that you can. There's no right way here. Just lift up and down. Squeeze the buttocks as you go. Up and down. Let's do it one more time. Make a good stay there, reaching long. Get that two-way stretch working in the body and slowly come down. Push your hips back to child's pose or a little piece of heaven, as we call it in Pilates. Take a deep breath in and breathe out. Go ahead and come to a seated position. And you did a great job. You worked with your band, you stretched your body out, you relieved stress in your spine, and you're ready to either get on with your day in a more relaxed way, or you're gonna get a great night's sleep tonight. Hi, I'm Mari Windsor, and this is Susanna Catrone from my Hollywood studio. After an illness or a stressful period where you haven't been able to do your regular workout routine, jumping back into that routine is not the best idea. Sometimes it's good to like take your time, do things slowly, get your body accustomed to, yes, we're working out again. So I've designed this workout just for you. If you do this workout after an illness for like say a week, 10 days, you're gonna be ready to get back into your regular routine. So, let's begin with some stretching. Sometimes if you've been lying in bed for a long time, your neck can get really stiff. So let's see if we can stretch it out some. Sit on one hand. That will prevent you from lifting up the shoulder, and I want you to keep your shoulder down as we stretch the neck to the side. Reach one arm up and curve the arm over and take the side of the head and gently pull and stretch. You don't want to do anything forced or anything too fast. This is all slow, controlled movement with the tummy always pulled in. Inhale, and as you exhale, you can increase the stretch a little bit if you can. If not, don't worry. Next time. Again, inhale and exhale, lengthen the neck. Good. Now turn the head. We're going to change positions to get a different part of the back of the shoulder and stretch. Inhale and exhale, keeping the shoulder down and the back nice and tall. Inhale and exhale. Come back to center and let's switch hands. Reach the arm up and take the arm across the head and gently pull. Inhale and exhale. Remember, the breathing is important, and try not to do this with the shoulders. I want you to try to sit up really tall when you're doing this. It gives you a better stretch and a better sense of your posture. That's it. So there's just not one thing we're doing here. That's the beauty of Pilates. It works the whole body all the time. Turn your head down and take a deep breath in and exhale out. When you inhale deeply and smoothly, you feed warm air and oxygen to the muscles so that the muscles can stretch a little bit more, they have a little bit more elasticity, and of course you feel better. It relaxes you too. It takes away some of that stress. And come up and facing front. That's it. Now release your hands, and we're just gonna shrug your shoulders up and down as if you were gonna have shoulders for earrings. Here we go. Up. And press it down, keeping the chest lifted up. Three more times. Up and press it down. Feel the shoulders working from the upper back, not just the shoulders, right? And up and press it down. Now you're ready for some circles. And circle forward. One and two. Make it nice and juicy. Feel every place that you go with it, right? And don't make a triangle or a square. Make a circle and reverse. And even if you can't get the same range of motion that you see here, do the best you can. Remember, it's all about doing the best that you can and getting in touch with your body and listening to what your body needs. All right, so now what we're gonna do is a chest expansion, but we're gonna modify it a little bit. And if you've had some lung problems, this is a great way to expand your lungs and get your lungs really healthy again. So inhale and reach your arms up, and then take an exhale, keeping your fingers reaching long and the shoulders down. Now exhale, take your fingertips to the side of your hips as you inhale. Hold your breath. Look to one side, look to the other side, back to the center, and exhale, reach the arms up. Again, inhale, press the air away from you and lift taller as you do. And look the opposite way, and look back to the center, and exhale up. Again, press the air away, lift your chest. That's it. Doesn't that feel good? Back to the center. Now, nice long exhale up and controlled breathing. Inhale. Hold your breath and look back to the center and exhale. Bring the arms up. Now, press the arms away from you one more time and just let the arms relax down the wrists on your knees. We're going to twist from the waist using the hands as a guide as you go, and you're going to look over your shoulder, keeping both sides of the rib cage long and your shoulders down. So you're going to look over your shoulder. Here we go. Twist. That's it. Come back to center. Again, twist and come back to center. Having the hand on the leg really does help to give you a point of reference and give you some support. Keep both sides equal. Don't, like, you know, collapse on one side. Twist a little bit more. That's it. And come back to center. Now we're going to do it a little bit quicker with three beats. You ready? This is great for the waistline. Pull up and one, two, hold three. One, two, hold three. Four more. One, two, hold three. And one, two, chest up. And come back to center. Now I want you to put your fingertips in front of you. Drop your head forward. Pull your ribs in. Walk your hands a little bit forward and round your back. Not too much, just a little. Make sure that your powerhouse or your tummy and your ribs are engaged and pulling back as the arms are reaching forward. That's going to make sure that we really stretch the back and curve it as much as possible. Let's take a breath here. Inhale and exhale. Make sure your neck is relaxed forward. We have a lot of weight in the head so that when you have your neck relaxed forward, you tend to stretch the back a little deeper. Again, one more breath. Inhale. Now, as you exhale, I want you to pull your tummy in and stack the vertebra up and sit up tall, right through the top of your head. Feel taller, as if I was pulling you up from your waist. Squeeze your buttocks together a little bit, and that will help you elongate in here. Now, bring one arm across your body. Hold on to the arm. I want you to look at your hand and look away. And look at your hand and look away. One more set. Look at your hand and look away. Come back to center and let's switch side. And hold. Feel that stretch. Look at your hand and look away. Look at your hand. Good. Keep the shoulder down and look away. That's it. And look at your hand and look away. Back to center and relax your arms down by your side. Now we're going to get ready to really increase the circulation in the body. We've done some stretching, so we're going to increase your circulation and warm up your heart and lungs with the Pilates 100, where we breathe smoothly in through the nose and out through the nose for a count of five until we reach 100. We'll be doing this in a modified way, so find the middle of your mat. If you need a pillow for your head, now's the time to get it. And roll down onto your back with control. Let's get into a modified position for the 100. So I want you to take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, pull the tummy in and then move the legs in towards you, because I don't want you to arch your back. So you have to use your tummy or your powerhouse to control. The legs are tabletop, parallel to the ceiling. We're going to pump the arms 100 times, actually. So if you have trouble pumping your arms, just simply keep your arms down by your side and think about this position, keeping stable, and do the breathing with us, all right? Now, if you want to lift your head, you may. Take a deep breath in and exhale, and lifting your shoulders and head off the mat so you're all supported everywhere. So roll down. We're going to demonstrate this with the head down. Reach your fingertips long so the shoulders stay long, and let's get ready to pump the arms. And inhale and exhale, breathing in through the nose for a count of five and out for a count of five. If you have sinus problems, you can always breathe through your mouth. Just make sure that it's deep and even. That's it. And inhale and exhale. Again, inhale. Now as you exhale, pull that tummy down, keep the ribs down, open the shoulders and keep reaching with your fingers. Inhale, heels together, squeeze your legs together. You'll get a little extra added bonus in your inner thighs. You you feel that in your inner thighs and your buttocks? Just a little glimmer. That's it. Good. And bend your knees in. Beautiful. I would take your hands underneath your legs, take a deep breath in, and gently pull the legs towards you for a little stretch in the back. Now, with control, nothing is fast or frantic. I want you to be in control of your body the whole time. So pull the tummy in and lower the feet down. You know, that reminds me that when you're sick or when you're recovering from something, you do feel out of control with your body. So the best way to get back into your regular routine is find a simple way to be in control, and this is it. Take your hands behind your leg, ribs in, lift up your head, and let's roll up with control. The legs are open about this much, down from your hips. Hands are underneath the legs and your elbows are open to the side. That will help you to keep your shoulders down. Pull the tummy in, pull the ribs in, round your back, let your neck relax forward, and inhale, lean back in this position until your arms are straight. Exhale, pull the tummy in deeper and come up. Again, inhale, lean back. Now I think you can go a little deeper here. What do you think? And exhale, pull this in and round up over your lower abs and come up and exhale. That's what I'm talking about. And inhale, keeping your back curved, and exhale, pulling up. One more time. Inhale. Now you want to deepen your powerhouse every time, so pull this in even deeper. That's it, squeeze your butt, and pull up and exhale. Now lean back. We're going to do an exercise called the astronaut. It's sometimes what they do in space to keep their tummies active. So reach your arms out and place your palms facing each other. Stay in this position and squeeze your buttocks and simply pull your tummy in a little bit more. If this is too much for you, then still hold on to your legs. That's absolutely fine. Inhale and exhale. Pull into that tummy, squeeze the buttocks. Now let's get the obliques a little bit on the side and twist from the waist. And hold it so you feel all along the side there, the oblique muscles. Just getting in touch, right? You want to keep this pulled in. Come back to the center with control. Nothing is fast, and with control we're going to move to the other side. Beautiful. Feel this side, the opposite side. Stay there and inhale. And exhale, pulling deeper as you exhale. And come back to center. Hold it 5 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Place your hands on your leg and roll down vertebra by vertebra on the mat with control from your powerhouse. Now, stretch both legs out without letting your lower back come off the mat. So again, it's a slow, controlled movement. And as you're lying here, feel the length of the body from the top of the head all the way to the tip of the toes. Be aware of your whole body because you're learning to listen again, right? You listen to all that other stuff. Now it's time to listen to the good stuff. So bring one knee into your chest, take the opposite hand, and pull the leg across the body so it's parallel to the mat, no further. And look opposite. Inhale and exhale. Again, inhale, lengthen this leg down, and exhale and come back to the center. Put the foot on the mat and lengthen out. Bring the other knee up, take the opposite hand, and pull across the body. No more than parallel to the floor. Don't overdo it. Inhale and exhale. Again, inhale. And as you exhale, pull the tummy in and roll yourself back to the center. Stretch the leg down. I want you to lie on your side and come to the back edge of your mat. Think about good posture here and bring your knees up so your chest is lifted and your hands together as if your hands were like a book, okay? And the knees are even with the hips. Now, you're going to inhale and reach the arm up and open the book and look at your hand, not too far on the first one. Good. Keep breathing deeply and evenly here. Go at your own pace. And pull to close. Again, reach with the arm nice and long, shoulders down. It feels graceful and beautiful. and come back. Make sure that when you reach that you keep one knee stacked on top of the other. One more time. And reach, go a little bit further this time. Give yourself a little challenge, right? That's it. And bring your arm to close. Let's go to the other side. Knees are even with the hips. Feet are straight down. And here's your book. Let's lift up that chest just a little bit more. Come back this way. There, now put the head down. That's it, good. Think about your good posture all the time. We're gonna open the book and reach. Look at the hand and inhale. Breathe at your own pace here. There's no set breathing. All right, just make it smooth and deep and even. And close the book. Again, inhale, open the book, keeping your hips stacked on top of one another. You'll feel a little stretch in your waistline and your torso and your neck and your shoulders. And close. One more time, let's just go a little bit quicker and reach and lengthen a little bit more. And close. Exhale. That was some beautiful work. So let's go ahead and lie down on your back. Bring your knees into your chest and give yourself a little stretch for your lower back and your hamstrings. Deep breath in and exhale out. Now release your hands, and as you slowly lower the legs, you're going to get a little stomach work by pulling this in as you lower the legs. So the tummy, or the powerhouse as we say, is supporting movement, right? Good. Take your fingertips on your shoulders. We're going to just roll the shoulders by bringing the elbows up and making a circle with the elbows. And the shoulders will do their work. That's all you have to think about doing. Just think about making circles with the elbows. Just relaxing, no big deal. And reverse. And up. And up. Keeping the ribs in, the back long, the tailbone long. Feel stable and secure. Take your hands on your legs and walk your hands back up, chin to your chest first. And come to a seated position. Come around to the front. That's a wonderful way to get your body back to working out. Like I said before, when you're out of control with your body, when you have an illness or there's something that you can't control and it stops you from doing everything, it's great to slowly get your body back in control and know that you are in control of your body and you can change.